Buzzer TV presents vintage game shows on Amazon.
Shuffle, cut, deal, and play. Someone's going to win today on Card Sharks. And here's the host of Card Sharks, Jim Perry.
Hi, thank you. Thank you very much, and welcome to Card Sharks. We're in the middle of a very exciting match, so we'd like to bring out our two players and get started. Thank you for joining us. Let's get to the cards. Janice and Ann, if you will, load in the cards. You can see we have a game in progress with these Card Sharks. Hello, Julie Cardenas, our champion. Nice to see you again, Julie.
Thanks. Glad I'm here.
Again, remind us about yourself.
Okay. I'm originally from Minnesota. I've been in Southern California for nearly 4 years. I'm a stewardess for a major airline, or flight attendant, I should say.
Oh, is there a difference?
Well, we used to be stewardesses. Now we're more commonly referred to as flight attendants.
You like that better?
Well, I guess I still feel as though I'm a stewardess.
Oh, okay. Nice to have you back, Julie. Our challenger, Linda Lamb. Hi, Linda. Nice to see you.
Hi, Jim. Good to see you again.
And again, would you remind us about yourself?
Yes, I'm a native Californian. I was born in a small town up by Fresno called Dinuba.
Dinuba.
Yes, yes. And it's a small farming community. And right now I'm living here in Los Angeles with my husband.
Good. Are you enjoying the big city more than the small country town?
It's much different, and I do enjoy it. Yes.
Well, we're delighted to have you back. We play the best 2 out of 3, and as we left off, Linda, you have the first game in the match and $100, so the pressure is on the champion. Good luck to both of you. Each player has their own deck of 52 playing cards shuffled and cut before we go on the air. The upper cards are red cards, will be played by the champion, Julie. The lower cards, the blue cards, will be played by the challenger, Linda. The object of the game, to work your way across the board, predicting whether each card is higher or lower than the one that precedes it. Before you can begin calling high-low with a card, you have to answer a high-low toss-up question based on a poll of 100 people. And we are in the sudden-death position. This is the final question of the game. Someone has to win with this play of the cards. Julie needs 2 cards to win. Linda needs 3. Control of the board, most important. That'll be decided by this question. As we left off, the question goes to you, Linda. We asked 100 women. In the last 24 hours, have you seen a naked man in print, in person, or on the screen? How many women said they had?
Oh, that's a loaded question.
That's why we asked it, Linda.
I had a feeling that you did. I don't think very many would have seen a naked man because they don't print pictures like that, except in girly magazines, and I don't know how many women looked at
those.
Well,
we said in person, in print, or on the screen.
I'd say 15.
15. You've seen a naked man in print, person, or on the screen. Julie, higher or lower?
Oh, I'm sure it's going to be higher. It's got to be higher.
Got it. Why does it have to be higher?
Well, because I'm sure that a few of them, I mean.
Okay, Julie. If it's higher, Julie, you'll go to the board first. If not, it'll be Linda. The actual number of women who have seen a naked man within the last 24 hours is 35. It's higher. Julie, it is sudden death. You need this game to tie. Listen carefully. You have an 8 as your base card, but you won the question. You have the right to change this card if you'd like. Try to turn those 2 cards over, but if you made a mistake, the game belongs to Linda. However, you can force Linda to play it off the ace. She cannot change it. It's a good card. She'd have to turn 3 cards over to win. Your decision. You want to play it or pass it, Julie?
I'll pass it.
You'll pass it. All right, Julie. You've got to call 3 cards correctly. If you do it, you have won 2 out of 3. You're the new champion. If you make a mistake, we've got a tie match. Call this card.
I sure give it a good try. Lower, please.
Lower than an ace. Yeah. It is a 10. 1/3 of the way there.
Lower.
Lower than a 10. It is a 3.
I hope the next card's higher.
If this is higher, we have a new champion for the win. Yes! Julie put the pressure on her, but she was equal to it. Julie, you're leaving us with $900.
That's great.
It's been
a profitable stay. I've had a lot of fun.
Thank you. You're a nice lady. Thank you for joining us. Linda, come on down here with me. You'll be be glad to. Yeah, this is the fun part coming up.
Oh, I've been looking forward to this.
We're going to be looking forward to the money cars worth thousands of dollars up there right after we take time out for this commercial message. Linda Lamb, our new champion with $200. Again, our congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Ready now for the money cards?
Oh, I think so. I'm going to give it my best shot.
Let's open the board and give it the best shot. Let's get to the money cards. Come on up here. Now then, Linda, you've got $200 for winning the game, yours to keep. We're going to give you new money to play with. This time you're going to bet that money. Starting on the bottom line with $200, bet that as you will with these three cards. Ann is dealing out. When you move to the second level, another $200 of betting money added, three more cards. $50 minimum bets until you get to the top card, the big bet. There you have to bet at least half the money. Good luck. Let's get good cards and play them well. Here's $200. And as in the game, you have a choice of two base cards. Your first one is a queen. Pretty good
card.
You want to keep it?
Yeah. I'd like to say the next one's going to be lower. I'm sorry. I'm going to bet all $200.
The whole thing? Oh, yes.
Yep.
That's the important thing. How much you're going to bet on
right.
it? Everything. $200.
Yes.
Lower than a queen. Oh, no.
Oh,
it's an ace.
No.
Well, you lose the money, but you're not out of it because that big
that's
ace
right.
is going to be moved
that's
up where we give you the other $200 of betting money.
And that's a great card.
And a great card. Four cards to go.
Okay. All of it. The next one's going to be lower.
$200 again, lower
yes.
than an ace. A jack.
Good.
Now you're up to $400
Good.
With a jack, Linda.
I'm going to bet $300 that it's going to be lower.
$300 lower than a jack.
No!
Oh, no.
A lot of high cards. You're down to $100 with a queen, Linda.
Well, I'm going to bet $50 that the next one's be lower.
Well, save one in reserve, right?
Right.
$50 lower than a queen. Ah, now we've got one. Finally, a five.
Good.
We move that five up. You've got to bet at least $75. You've got $150.
I'm going to bet all of it.
Okay.
But the next one will be higher.
All right. Yeah. Higher than a five, $150. Come on.
Yeah! Oh!
$300. Not thousands, but not bad.
No,
come
not
on
at
down
all.
Here with me, Linda. And with the $200 in the game, it's $500.
That's very fine with me.
That's profitable. I'll take it all myself. We'll meet a new challenger right after this. Linda, our champion, are you ready to meet a new challenger?
Yes.
Let's deal out the card, Janice, with two brand new decks of cards for this match as we meet our next player on Card Sharks. Hello there, Debbie Robinson. Hi, Debbie. Nice to meet you.
Hi. I work for a supermarket part-time, and my husband and I like backpacking and whitewater rafting.
Good. Are you nervous, Abby?
Yes, I'm so nervous.
I know, because I just said hello. I didn't say tell us about yourself or anything. Did you memorize that, Debbie?
No, actually, I just made it up last second.
Oh. Can you say it again, Debbie? Tell us about yourself.
Oh, I work part-time for a supermarket, and my husband and I like backpacking and the thrill of whitewater rafting.
You added thrill that time, Debbie. Nice to have you here, Debbie. Relax, you're among friends, and we want you to have a good time. You'll play the lower cards, Debbie, the blue cards, while Linda plays the upper cards, the red cards. We start with a question to you, Linda. Our man on the street went to Paris, France, where he asked 100 people, do you approve of young couples living together before they are married? How many Parisians do approve of couples living together before marriage?
Oh, the man on the street sure gets around.
Yes, he does.
And I think Parisians have a fairly strict morality code. I would say very few. I'm going to guess 25.
25 out of 100 Parisians approve of couples living together before marriage. Debbie, is that higher or lower, do you think?
I don't think anybody really approves of it, so I'm going to have to say higher, just to go with the odds.
Going with the odds, say
yeah.
higher. The actual number of Parisians who do approve of couples living together before marriage is 94, much higher. Wow. The old saying, 94 Frenchmen can't be wrong. Debbie, your base card is a 2. Off to a great start.
All right, it's going to be higher.
Higher than a 2. It's a 10.
Oh, 10.
Remember, you can
freeze
at any time.
I'm going to freeze.
You're going to freeze right there on the 10, keeping Linda away from the cards. Question to you, Debbie. We took a confidential poll of 100 married women and asked them, have you ever secretly picked up an extension phone to eavesdrop on your husband's conversation? How many women admitted they had eavesdropped?
Oh, I think quite a few, but I would say around 35.
35. You ever done that, Debbie?
Yes.
Yes? Higher or lower, Linda?
I think a lot of women do that too. But I don't think it's as many as 35. I'm going to say lower.
You say lower?
Yeah.
You ever done it?
Once? Yeah.
Did you learn anything?
No. Wasn't even interested.
The actual number of nosy women who had eavesdropped on their husband's phone conversation is 20. It's lower. Linda. And we have two of them right here. Linda, your base card is a queen.
That's a good card. Yeah, I'm going to go lower.
Lower than a queen. It's a six.
Okay. I'm going to go ahead and say higher.
Continuing on, higher than a six, a ten.
Good. I'm going to freeze.
And you'll freeze it. Needing two cards, Debbie needs three. Linda, the question to you. We asked 100 priests across the country, do you think women should be allowed to become Catholic priests? How many priests said women should be allowed to become priests?
Oh, dear. I don't know. I just have no way of guessing. I wouldn't think that they would be too much in favor of it. It's always been a man's work. I would say five.
Five out of 100 said yes, women should be allowed to become priests. Debbie, higher or lower?
From my information, I don't think the woman is supposed to be the head of the church, but I think five might be a little low, so I'm going to hope it's higher.
You say higher. I never know the answers in some of the polls like this one. I'm curious to find out the answer. The actual number of priests who think women should be allowed to become priests is 39. It's higher, Debbie. Wow.
Change that card, please.
You're entitled to change the 10 to a 9. Oh. Not a good change, but you've got to play that one.
I'm going to go lower.
Lower than a 9. It is another 9. It is not lower. You lose it. Linda, play off the 10. You can't change it. Call this.
Okay, I'll give it a try and say it's going to be lower.
Lower than a 10. No, it's an ace.
Yep.
And we'll fill in the spaces, Janice, please. And we go to the fourth and final question. Debbie, it's sudden death. Someone has to win on this play. We asked 100 men who are senior citizens, have you ever smoked marijuana? How many men, senior citizens, said they had?
I don't think that many have. Oh, no. I'm going to say 10.
10 men, senior citizens, have smoked marijuana, Linda, higher or lower?
I can't even imagine the 10 have smoked marijuana. I'm going to say lower.
Lower than that. The actual number of men, senior citizens, who have smoked marijuana is 4. It's much lower, Linda.
Good.
Linda, you've got control. You have the right to change this 10 and try to turn these two cards over. But remember, you can force Debbie to play off the 9 and try to play these three cards. One mistake, and the game is yours.
I'm going to let Debbie play her cards.
You're going to force Debbie to play it. Debbie, if you turn them all over, you've won the first game of the match. One mistake, and Linda wins it. You have a 9. Call this.
Well, I'm going to go with the odds and say lower.
Lower than a 9. It is a 6. One third there. Higher than a 6. It is a big ace.
Lower
for the win. Yes, it's a 7, and she did it. 1-0. Favor the challenger. Janice, if you'll set up for the next game, please. Kind of like getting that ace there, Debbie.
I'd like some more.
Well, Linda, what do you think of your strategy now?
Well, it didn't pay off this time, but I think I'd do it again.
All right, Linda. Debbie, you lead 1-0. You've got one game and $100. Janice is going to deal out the cards. Same two decks of cards. Linda, the question to you. You need this game. We asked 100 married women. Who suggested marriage first, you or your husband? How many women said their husband suggested marriage first?
I think quite a few men do the suggesting. I'm going to say 55.
55. 55 men suggested marriage first, Debbie.
I think that women usually suggest it first, so I'm going to say higher.
Now the question was, how many women said the husband suggested marriage first?
As long as that's
clear, you can say whatever you like.
Okay, then I'm going to say lower.
You're going to say lower, because you think the women suggested
first. I think the women.
The actual number of married women who said their husband suggested marriage first is 82. It's not lower, Linda. Wow.
Good.
Yes, the men do most of it. Linda, you're looking at a 4. Do you want it?
Yeah, not bad card. I'd like to say the next one be higher.
Higher than a 4. It is a jack.
Good. I'm going to go ahead and say the next one will be lower.
Lower than a jack? It's a 3.
Oh, good. I'm going to keep going and say the next one will be higher.
Higher than a 3. It's an 8.
Oh, freeze.
Freezing it right there. Yeah. Do not want to risk those cards. Uh-uh. Linda, you need just one card to tie up this match. Debbie, we pulled 100 married men and asked them, who suggested marriage first, you or your wife? How many men said they suggested marriage first?
Well, I'm going to play it safe and say 50.
50. Put all the pressure on you, Linda. Higher or lower than 50?
She sure has. I'm going to say that I think men still do the suggesting, like I said before. I'm going to say it's higher.
You say even higher. Mm-hmm. You think the men figure they do it.
Yeah.
The actual number of married men who suggested marriage first is 83. Oh. You got it, Linda. And it was just about the same, so nobody was lying there. Linda, you got an 8. Do you want it?
No. Let's change it, please.
Change it to a 6. Call this card.
Okay. I got to go with the odds and say it's going to be higher.
If this is higher, you've tied up the match. Yes, you got it. It's a queen. And you've tied it up. Each player with one game and $100, the tiebreaker with just 3 cards and 3 questions coming up right after this. We've got a tie, 1-1. Challenger with one game, champion with one. Let's set up for the tiebreaker, please. Ladies, we'll move over the bar. Set up with just 3 cards, 3 questions. Question to you, Linda. We asked 100 housewives across the country. Did your husband kiss you goodbye this morning? How many housewives said yes?
Well, I'm speaking from my personal experience. My husband kisses me goodbye every single morning.
That's very nice.
I think a lot of husbands do. At least I'd like to think they do. So I will say that 58.
58 said yes. They got a kiss goodbye this morning. Debbie, higher or lower?
I'm not so sure that the wives are up when the husbands leave for work. Oh, I just don't know.
What do you think?
Oh, I'm going to go higher and
higher.
Hope.
The actual number of happy housewives who were kissed goodbye is 69. It's higher, Debbie. Debbie, your base card for this tiebreaker is a king.
Oh, it's going to be lower.
Lower than a king. It's a 3.
It's going to be higher.
If this is higher, we have a new champion. Yes, it's a queen. She did it. Congratulations. Linda, you're leaving us with $600.
Oh, thank you so much.
Thank you for joining us, Linda. Bye-bye. Debbie, come on down here. I think you're happy. And she hasn't even won a lot of money yet.
I know. I'm going to, though.
That's good. I hope she does it right after this. Don't go away. That's it. All right, Debbie, you've had a moment to compose yourself.
I know.
Ready to go now.
I'm better.
Thousands of dollars up there. Let's get set up, Anne, if you will. That $200 you've won, yours to keep. New money to play with, new cards, all shuffled and cut. $200 on one level, $200 on the second level. But boy, if you can double them up, it adds up to a lot of money. $28,800 is possible. Half the money, of course, in the big bet. Good luck, Debbie. You're enthusiastic. I hope you win. $200.
Thank you.
And your first of 2 base cards, if you need them, is a 4.
Oh, all right.
Want to play that?
It's higher.
How much money now? Remember,
$200. It's higher.
Right, be careful. Don't get carried away with your enthusiasm.
$200.
Right. Higher than a 4. It's a jack.
All right.
$400, Debbie, and now you've got a jack.
I'm going to go $300 that it's lower.
$300.
Right.
Lower than a jack. It's an 8.
Oh,
$700.
I'm going to go $100 that's lower.
$100.
Yeah.
Lower than an 8. A
2.
Oh, a 2. Great card.
All right.
$800. A great card. The 2 moves up. We add $200. Debbie, you've got $1,000.
Oh, $1,000 and it's higher.
The whole thing. $1,000 higher than a 2. Yeah, it's a 9.
All right.
$2,000 now, Debbie. Think about it. Be careful. You've got a 9. You've got
$2,000. $200 that it's lower.
$200.
Yeah.
Lower than a 9. Let's see if we can get another deuce. Lower than a 9. No, it's a king.
That's all right.
Oh, but you held back. You got a good trade.
A good
You've got $1,800 and a great card, a king.
I'm going to go $1,500 that's lower.
$1,500. Can you believe it? You're the one who did
it. I believe it.
$1,500 lower than a king. Yeah, it's a 2.
Oh, I can't believe it.
Ooh, a great card. Debbie?
All of it! All of it is higher!
You're gonna bet it all!
All of it!
$3,300! Debbie, with this card, you will have $6,600 or absolutely nothing. Higher than a 2. Yeah, it's a 4! Come on, Debbie! Congratulations!
wonderful.
I know you can.
Can you use that money?
Oh, yes.
Debbie, you've got $6,800 now on card sharks. Congratulations, you're a fine champion. We'll meet a new champion the next time we meet on card sharks. Good job.
A representative of the studio audience will receive American Electric's kitchen appliances, including the work-saving American food processor. It cuts, shreds, chops, pairs, slices, blends, grinds, and grates. It can turn a cook into a chef furnished by American Electric Corporation. And some of our contestants will receive Mary Kay Cosmetics. Be everything you can be with skincare and glamour cosmetics presented to you in your home by trained beauty consultants Mary Kay Cosmetics, Dallas, Texas. And Cool Ray, fashionable sunglasses that win admiring stares while protecting from annoying glare. 86 eye-catching style. See what you're missing with Cool Ray polarized sunglasses. And from Gallery of Homes, a book on home improvements. Gallery of Homes brokers, if you're selling or buying a home, you'll find they do their homework. And Quizel Lighting, your choice of one of these brass finished table lamps with bronze highlighting, complements traditional and contemporary settings. This is Gene Woods speaking for Card Sharks. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. We'll be right back.